For a closer look at the voter sentiment in the West and how it differed from the rest of the country, I want to bring in Keith Brownsey. He's a political science professor at Mount Royal University, joining me from our Calgary studio. And Professor, we want to focus specifically on the West. You heard what Andrew Scheer had to say there. Is the disenfranchisement of voters from Alberta and Saskatchewan, does that lie at the feet of Justin Trudeau?
Oh, I don't think so. I think the issues are much larger. They have to do with the decline of the oil and gas industry and the perceived inaction of various governments, including the former Harper government, in aiding the oil and gas industry, diversifying markets, pipelines being built, all of that sort of thing. So these are deep frustrations, but it's not exactly the West either. It's Saskatchewan and Alberta. Manitoba elected Liberals, Conservatives, and New Democrats. BC, of course, did the same thing. So it's Alberta and Saskatchewan. That seems to be defined by the define the West these days.
Right. Okay. Well, that's a really good point. But when you look at the breakdown of the national map, it does seem split up into its own individual countries, three of them in particular. You know, they've got the Bloc Québécois in Quebec, and then we've got this Western alienation feel in Alberta and Saskatchewan. And you see the differing, you know, regions there. How can Trudeau build some bridges now and mend some fences?
Well, I don't know if he really has to do much more than he has already. If the Trans Mountain Expansion Pipeline is completed, and it will be within several years, I think that will alleviate a lot of the tension. It's that simple. But bringing back the oil and gas industry to the mid-2000s, where oil was at $80 to $100 a barrel, while natural gas was, you know, $15 a gigajoule, that isn't going to happen. And there's nothing any government, at least a Canadian government, can do about that.
So you're saying that's an industry that's gone the way of the dodo bird in terms of getting those prices for Canadian oil?
It may have gone that way. And what we see in Alberta and Saskatchewan is frustration with that. I mean, thousands, tens of thousands of people have been laid off in the oil and gas industry in this part of the world. And they've been sitting around for a couple of years hoping that prices come back. Now, that may happen, but it's not a certainty. And they've simply taken out their anger on the current federal government. We also have to remember that Mr. Harper was in office for 10 years, and yeah, some pipelines were built, but the main problem there were with the United States, getting the Keystone XL built, getting Line 3, as it's called, into Minnesota and other places. Mr. Harper didn't do an awful lot to promote the oil and gas industry in terms of access to markets.
Yeah, Professor.
Mr. Trudeau bought the damn pipeline.
Well, I was just going to say to some who forget, the Liberal government did buy a pipeline, really winning no fans on either side of the argument, because you say the pipeline's going to be built like it's actually going to be built. But I'm from BC, and that province is not open to having a pipeline go through its backyard.
It's all been approved. No more legislation need be passed. Whatever court cases exist now will be over in a few months. That pipeline is going to go through. I don't see any way around it. And there was a lot of talk in conservative circles in Alberta. I mean, this is borders on conspiracy that the Liberal government bought the TMX simply to shut it down. Well, that's absolute nonsense. There are many more ways they could have shut down the TMX rather than spend $4.6 billion. No, that pipeline will go through.
If it will go through, why didn't they get any votes at all in Alberta?
That remains to be seen. As I said, there was these conspiracy theories floating around. Jason Kenney and the Progressive and the United Conservative Party at the provincial level certainly promoting these ideas. You know, blaming the federal Liberals, attacking Bill C-69, Bill C-48 as detrimental to the oil and gas industry. It worked up a lot of anger.
I need to let you go because we're almost out of time, but you are from that area. Do you feel a sense of alienation, Professor?
I do not feel any sense of alienation, no. I hear a lot of it on the far right, and it will be the Conservatives' talking point for the next 18 months, 24 months. But no, not a lot of alienation on my part.
Professor Keith Brownsey, good to talk to you. Appreciate your time today. Thank you.
You're welcome.